Good afternoon, everyone. This is Chrissy from Van Aan & Company. It's Friday, September 22nd. I'm going to go over the markets for the day and week. So we had a lot of strength here into these grain markets. Looked like there wanted to be buyers coming in to finish the week. Corn market up 3.25 cents on the day. That puts it just over a penny lower here on the week. Biggest mover of the day was soybeans, as you're starting to just hear stories of a lot of demand showing up and you're wanting to be buyers, especially since you broke through the price count of 977, broke through a 200-day moving average. And technical traders are thinking that this could go to the next price count of 970 or 997. So a lot of technical support there. Hearing that yields are very strong coming in. So it's not an actual supply issue, but it does seem like they want to be buyers of this market here, up 13.5 cents on the day, up 15.5 cents on the week. Into the wheat markets, not as much there, with Chicago wheat down 3 cents on the day, close to steady on the week. Minneapolis wheat up 10.5 cents on the day. So that came close to the close of the day here, had a lot of buying coming in, closing up 13.25 cents on the day or on the week. And then over the Kansas City week, steady on the day, up 4 cents on the week. So broad-based support here, except corn really struggling to move much away from that 350 price count on a D's corn. So traded a little bit below it earlier in the week, a little bit above it in the end, and just really no movement there. Over in the meat markets, big movers this week here. Cash trade came in at 108 live today. That's a big move. That's up $3 to $5 over the last week or two. So a lot of support there in the futures market showed it as well. Live cattle up just over $1 on the day, up almost $4 on the week. Feeder cattle steady, close to steady on the day, up over $3 on the week. And then lean hogs a lot lower. So down $1.62.5 today, down over $5 on the week. You did have cattle on feed cold storage come out after the close here at 2 o'clock. That was a little bit unfriendly. So you should be seeing some pressure, some profit taking coming in early to next week, unless that was priced into today's action. But overall, a little bit of a negative report there. Moving forward, what we're going to be watching, we're going to get some more yield reports moving forward. We'll start to hear quite a few more, especially onto those bean market. That'll be important for the market. Then also seeing if these technical traders are able to take beans to that next price count of 997. I have to close with the disclaimer: trading in futures and options involves risk loss, may not be suitable for all producers. Have a great weekend.